Hey lovely people, what is Six Sigma yellow belt, green belt, black belt, master black belt, and you have somewhere white belt as well. And there are a few organizations, they have their own customized belt, like orange belt, blue belt. Sounds funny, right? I have another question for you. What are the different roles that you have in your organization when you're doing a project? I have seen team member, process owner, mentor, champion, and sponsor. Let me know if you have something else. So in today's video, I'm going to cover all these questions, and towards then I'll tell you the secret. How do you make sure that your project doesn't fail because of this reason? I have personally failed in few projects where people were not aware about their role and responsibility. This is an important question when you start a project, right? Well, hi. My name is Dhirendra. I'm a certified Lean Six Sigma Master Black Belt, certified over 17,000 Lean Six Sigma professionals, certified Agile Ninja Coach, and Professional Scrum Master, and did several other certifications. So let's get started now. First question, what are the different levels that we have? We have Yellow Belt, Green Belt, Black Belt, and Master Black Belt. What is Yellow Belt? And I know that you're going to ask, what is white belt first of all? So white belt is the very basic level, which is, I don't think it is existing in any enterprise right now. But that was like, you know, very, very basic 3 to 4 hours of session, wherein you kind of give an overview about what is quality, Six Sigma, and all this. It is a learning phase. You do not do any project till then, okay? But when you talk about the level one as a yellow belt, typically, a yellow belt should be around 7 to 8 hours of classroom training, and after that, you should write exam. You might showcase one small project and you get certified. I know you'd be thinking that, oh, Dhirendra, I have seen in YouTube 1 hour, 1.5 hour, 2 hours, and people get certified in yellow belt. Please, that's not yellow belt, okay? So that's really funny, but that's not yellow belt. That's basic thing. Once you complete a yellow belt, you will be able to do a small project. Okay, what should we cover in yellow belts, right? We talk about basic statistics, lead management, then we talk about how the DMAX cycle works. It's quite expensive in that. So who should do that? Anybody, like team members, your machine operator, any fresher, anybody can go for yellow belt. So there is no prerequisite. All right, so the second level that we have is a green belt. What is green belt is anyone who will attend the training for minimum 50 to 60 hours. I know you'll be again surprised. You'll have seen that training is there for 2 days, 3 days in any enterprise. Please, that's not the green belt actually, right? Green belt training is 7 to 8 days training with a minimum 50 to 60 hours, each day equal to 8 hours. That's where you will call yourself a green belt if you submit a small project. And I know that's there in your organization as well. There can be minor customization. Okay, who should do that? Anyone who wish to make their career as a supervisor, as a team leader, or QA, quality analyst kind of role, you can actually do green belt. What is the next level that we have is black belt. Now, once you are done with the green belt, you can go for black belt. Typically, a black belt session should be, including green belt, should be 15 to 16 days of classroom training, each day equal to 8 to 9 hours, so you can say 160 plus hour of training. I know that you would have never seen any institution, any places where you get this, but that is what the reality is of black belt, okay? Once you understand all these concepts, you also need to do minimum 1 or 2 projects, then you get certified. Right? So if you don't do these projects, it's like you know about what are the exercises you should do to reduce the weight, but you never go to gym. Sounds really funny, right? So you should actually do some of the project and then say you're a certified Lean Six Sigma Black Belt. Okay, that's the next level. Who should do that? Anybody who wants a managerial level role can do a Six Sigma Black Belt training and certification. Okay? And of course, that you can do from your enterprise as well, your organization. You can approach any good, proper training institution. When I say good means, please check out about the duration, especially credibility, and if you are getting a project opportunity there. All right. Now, next level is Master Black Belt. Till black belt, you can do it directly, but can you reach to master black belt? I would say once you are done with a black belt, minimum 3 to 5 years of experience that I recommend personally, you should have as a black belt, and minimum 200 hours of training, then you should apply for master black belt. Because when you do a master black belt role in any enterprise, you have to identify project, you have to select team member, you have to look at the cost, what is there, okay, how you reduce the cost, what is the organization mission, and so on. You have a huge responsibility and you kind of certify people. Okay, so that's what you will be doing as a master black belt. Now, as a master black belt, of course, that again goes 10 to 12 days training. Do not think it is 1 or 2 days or 3 days training and you're going to be a master black belt. No, that's, you are just making yourself happy. Okay, you're a master black belt. That's not it. All right. So these are the different levels that we have seen in the industry right now. Okay. When it comes to the project, now whoever is doing the project, if he is a green belt, he become a project leader. If he's a black belt, he become a project leader. Okay. Now green belt typically, you would have seen they can do a project, but that's a smaller project because many organizations, they will not hire you on full-time basis. You will have certain responsibility. Along with that, you'll be performing a role of process improvement, and that's what you do as a green belt. Yeah. Next level is, like when you talk about a black belt, mostly like many organizations, they will have a full-time role for a black belt where the person is responsible for only driving continuous improvement. He has to do maybe, 8 to 10 projects in a year, and he will be training people in yellow belt, green belt, and so on. That's what black belt does. MBB will just allocate resources, monitor the project, review, approve. That's what they do. Tollgate review and the stuff. So when you are doing a project, coming to role and responsibility now, when you're doing a project, you become a project leader. You, even if you're a green belt or black belt, it doesn't matter. Okay? Then you need a team member. That's the first thing that you needed. What do you mean by team members? How much we should have? Around 3 to 5 team members are good enough, but make sure you are not just taking only your friends. Okay, so you need to make sure there's a mix of skill. You don't need to take all 3 or 4 people from the similar team, similar department. That can create a problem. Okay, so make sure when you're taking a 3 to 4 people, let's say one person you're taking from IT, second from the operation, third is from quality, fourth is from facility, and so on, just to see that, you know, different perspective as well. Right? So you first understand who all will be there in your team. Now there's a catch. When you're selecting a team member, please be careful. Please be super, super careful. When I was doing a Six Sigma project, when I used to report and I used to tell management, please, I need these many people. They will make sure they are keeping some, a few team members. They are not at all protector. Okay. And they are not good performer as well. So please make sure when you're selecting them, you have a proper interview. You ask the reason why they are coming. It should not be like because they just want to spend the time or they just want to get the name in a project, they are coming and they don't value. So have the proper selection process. Look at their historical performance as well. That's important. Once you select a 3 to 5 team member, what they have to do, let me talk about that in a very, very precise manner. They'll be helping you in a data collection, arranging a brainstorming session, and maybe coordinating with different stakeholders, preparing a basic documentation. So that's what team members will do largely. Now, when you are doing a project, you can have sometimes team member who is green belt, yellow belt, or sometimes no belts. And I say no belts, even if they are not Six Sigma certified, you can still take them in a project team as a team member. Okay? I'm sure you are making notes as well, by the way, so that you can apply them. Next thing, once you are done with this team member selection, you also have somebody called mentor. Now, you can't select mentor, but most of the time, organization will have one person, especially from your department or your area, as a mentor who will largely help you with the process-related information and so on. Okay. So it's kind of go-to person on daily basis, alternate day basis. You can reach out to him asking that, what are the tools I should do? How's it? Sometimes MBB will also work or act as a mentor. Sometimes black belt will act as a mentor if green belt is doing a project. It really varies or depending on the scenario. So mentor is another role who will be helping project leader on regular basis for small and bigger issues. Okay. Now, what are the different roles? We spoke about team member, we spoke about project leader, and then we have a project mentor. Next, we have process owner. Who is process owner? Generally, a person who owns the process. Okay, if I'm doing a project in training department, maybe the training manager or training lead or training head is my process owner because he is responsible for all the benefit and losses that happen, right? So he's a process owner. If I'm doing a project in HR, then HR manager become my process owner. Okay, so this is also clear. Next thing which we have is champion. Now champion, looks some people, they are confused. They think after master black belt we have a champion level. No, please, champion is not the level. Champion is just one role during a project. Okay, so what he does is, he or she, champion will be responsible in terms of coordinating between Six Sigma team and management team. Now let's say you are facing some challenge in terms of finance, some resources are not helping, they are not coming for your meeting, they are not supporting with the data. You get stuck. You can reach out to champion. But do not, so most of the champion are not expected to be MVP. So please do not reach out to them for technical thing, asking that, hey, how can I do man between test? Or how can I do Kruskal Valley test? All these are by the Six Sigma test, statistical test which you'll be learning. That's another important thing. So once you have a champion, you are not going to select champion. Management will decide a champion. Typically, for 500 people, they will have like 200 to 500 people, they will have one champion. When I used to head quality, I used to have champion for every 500 people, one champion, depending on where or how critical your business is. Then we will also have something called sponsor or executive sponsor. Now the word is very, very clear that anybody who pay the money, who fund the project, who provide you resources, who's responsible for rewards and recognition. That's what we call project sponsor. Okay, so we spoke about team member. Let me summarize. Person who will help you with the data collection and all. We have project leader, can be green belt, black belt, and sometimes yellow belt as well. We will have a mentor. Anybody who is superior, it can be a supervisor, it can be a process owner, anybody. Then we spoke about process owner who own that process. And we spoke about champion, someone who is coordinating between Six Sigma team and management team, providing all the resources, ensuring there's no roadblock. And then we spoke about executive sponsor, who generally fund the project. Hope this is clear. Now, two things we spoke. One is the level, second is the roles that you have. Now, do not reach out to MBB for some financial challenges because he may not be able to help you. Financial issues, champion is the right person. We often get confused there, okay? Second thing which I want to tell you is I have personally failed in few projects. So I have done more than 700 projects in any kind of industry, whether it's manufacturing, service, defense, or whatever. So how it works is, when you are doing a project, you may face challenge in terms of data collection, team member not showing the interest. There are many challenges happen. And biggest challenge that I have faced is clarity of role and responsibility. Now, what is that? Suppose a team leader is, or project leader is doing something, he will be thinking maybe project member, team member will do that. Team member would think that mentor will do it. Okay? So there's a confusion always. Especially when you are an in-house black belt, you will definitely face that problem wherein your team member may not support you or mentor may not support you, right? Because you are part of system sometime. So what you have to do is, before you start a project, make a proper agreement, kind of discussion with the stakeholder, especially in the toll gate or project kickoff meeting, who will have what responsibility. Suppose, if I expect that a team member should go ahead, collect the data, arrange a session, I will have that particular documented already. If I expect a mentor to help me on alternate day basis, I will document that as well. If I expect maybe a champion to help me in something, they should do that. If I expect he should approve, I will write him as approver. So there are a couple of approaches like Army, RASIC, which are used to define that who should have what role and responsibility even during the project life cycle. Similarly, you can create your own document. You don't have to go for a standardized one. You can just write who will do what in each phase. that will make sure your project is successful. So I think with this, I have covered all three things. Please comment in case you have some other bells, some other level in your organization, or if you are facing any other challenge related to project, I'll be really happy to help you. Okay. Do share this, subscribe this, because I'm going to upload many more videos related to Six Sigma, which are truly mind-blowing, absolutely from my experience, and will definitely help. Okay. Thank you so much. Take care. This is Dhiren signing off.